Okay, we're going to look at polynomial functions in section 5.1. And first we're going to look at some terminology. A monomial is really a chunk or one-term expression. For example, if I have something like 3x squared, that would be a monomial. Or maybe if I have something like 5x, that would be a monomial. Or if I have something like 10, that would also be a monomial. The key term is that the exponent has to be positive or 0, because I could technically have an x to the 0 here. So I can't have negative exponents, I can't have radicals or fractional exponents. A monomial is basically a one chunk, one term. Binomial is two terms. So for example, something like 3x squared plus 5x would be a binomial. It has two chunks joined with a plus. Trinomial would, as you might have guessed, is three terms, so something like 3x squared plus 5x minus 10 would be a trinomial because it has three terms or three chunks. Again, all the exponents are positive or zero in this case, where you don't see a variable at all. A polynomial has many terms. So for example, let's say I have 3x to the third plus 5x squared minus 4x plus 2. That has four terms. We tend to just call it a polynomial. Now all the previous cases, all of these are special cases of a polynomial. Monomial, binomial, trinomial are all smaller ones of a polynomial. The degree of a polynomial is the highest exponent or highest sum. Here's what I mean. If I have something like 3x squared plus 5x plus 2, the highest exponent you see there is 2, so the degree would be 2. If I'm looking at this next polynomial that has a combination of x's and y's in each chunk, then I have to look at the sum of them. This is a 1, 2 plus 1 is 3. This is a 1, this is a 1, 1 and 1 is 2, and that doesn't have any variables, so I don't worry about it. So I pick the biggest sum, which means this would have degree 3. Also note that if you have a polynomial, in this case a monomial, that has no variables, then the degree is going to be 0. So if you don't see any variables, that means that maybe there was a variable like an invisible x to the 0, so the degree is actually 0. Coefficient is really the number attached to the variable. So if I have like 5x, the coefficient is 5. So the coefficient of this term is 5. You could have each term having, of course, its own coefficient. I can say the coefficient of x here would be 3. The coefficient of x squared would be 5. Descending order. Descending order means the exponents appear from bigger to smaller. For example, if I give you 5x minus 2x cubed plus 5x squared minus 1, that would be all out of order. It wouldn't be in descending order. Descending order would be to take it, put it from the biggest, then the next biggest, then just an x, then the constant term at the very end. So descending order exponents should appear in order from biggest to smallest. Next thing we want to look at is adding and subtracting polynomials. And the only thing we're going to do is we just touch the coefficients, not the variables and their exponents, and we combine like terms. So adding and subtracting, we actually have done already. For example, if I give you something like these two binomials, first binomial, second binomial, the parentheses I can remove because I'm only adding, and I can just combine like terms and say 3x and 4x gives me 7x, 2 and negative 1 give me a positive 1. So all we do is combine like terms. Let's subtract these two trinomials. Again, because it's subtraction, I have to distribute the negative. So I'm just going to write them out, distribute the negative. And then as before, remember I'm distributing the negative, so that's a minus 3x squared and a minus 4x and a plus 3. So I just combine like terms. I have these guys that are like terms. And then I have these guys that are like terms. And then I got the constant, negative 2 and positive 3. And I just combine those like terms, like 5 apples minus 3 apples leaves me with 2 apples. Remember, we're not touching the exponents or the variables. 11x minus 4x is positive 7x, negative 2, and positive 3 is a positive 1, and we're done with adding or subtracting our two trinomials. Evaluating polynomial functions is just like when we were evaluating any other function or any other linear function that we looked at before. Evaluate p of 2 simply means replace the x with negative 2 and see what it pops out. So all I'm going to do is replace all the x's with negative 2. That's 2 order of operations times 4. Do the exponent first. Positive 10 minus 2. So that's 8 plus 10 minus 2, which gives me 18 minus 2, which is a 16. So p of negative 2 spits out a positive 16. In other words, if I were looking at the graph of this thing, the x-coordinate negative 2 would have a corresponding y-coordinate 16. Given two functions f and g, find these three different things that we're supposed to do. So the first one, this new notation simply doesn't mean f plus g times 3. It actually means the input is 3 for both functions. So f grabs a 3, g grabs a 3, and then whatever those are, we add them. So there's two things that get spit out, one from the f function, one from the g function. Now what do I have for the f function? F function is 2x minus 1, so 2 times 3 minus 1, that's 6 minus 1, which is 5. That's just going to wait right there. G also gets a 3, so that's 3 squared minus 1. That's 9 minus 1, which is 8. Now what happens with these two is that big plus, so the input for both functions is 3, and their sum looks like it's going to be a 13. So f plus g of 3 is actually equal to 13. Same thing for part B. 2 gets grabbed by both f and g, and then whatever they spit out gets subtracted. So I have two functions that are going to get evaluated at that value of 2, x coordinate 2. So that's going to be f is 2x minus 1, 2 times 2 minus 1, 4 minus 1, which is 3. Same thing, we go for the g function and put in the 2. 2 squared minus 1, that's 4 minus 1, which is also a 3. And what operation do we do with these guys? We subtract them, and that spits out a 0. So f minus g of 2 is actually equal to 0. Now what's the deal with part C? It's the same idea. Both functions grab the x value of x because it's an unknown x. So I'm looking at f of x and I'm looking at g of x, and they both get added together. So what they grabbed is this unknown value that I don't really know what it is, but I can always go and see what f of x is and just put it right there. So basically, I have my f of x gets copied down right here exactly as it appears, and my g of x gets copied exactly as it appears. And again, why does that happen? Because the input is an unknown x, and then I just add those two guys. And when I add these, I combine like terms. I have x squared, and then the 2x is all by itself, and then negative 1 and negative 1 give me a negative 2. So f plus g of x got an input of x and gives me some output in terms of x. These guys got inputs as numbers and gave me outputs of numbers. These guys got inputs of x's and gave me an output in terms of x's. This is kind of like the global function that takes care of all of these guys. This is f plus g of all the x's. This is f plus g of only 3. Now this, like I said, is the global function. If I want to, I can check part A right here. Since this is the global function that was added, and this tells me to add them at the location 3, if I put 3 in here, I better get the same answer as I got in part A. So let's see, 3 squared plus 2 times 3 minus 2, that gives me 9 plus 6 minus 2, that's 15 minus 2, which is equal to 13, and it checks out. So this is the global sum for all the x's. This is just the sum for the x value 3. Let's do their difference quickly too. X gets pulled by the f and the g functions, and then they get subtracted. Now f of x up above was 2x minus 1 right here, and the other guy g was x squared minus 1. So 2x minus 1, and this guy is x squared minus 1. Now be careful, when you have a minus, that minus is going to affect everybody after it. So these parentheses are absolutely necessary, whereas here for the sum, they weren't. So don't forget to distribute, that's a common mistake. 2x minus 1 minus x squared plus 1, because this guy, the bold negative, gets distributed into both of them. Now I end up with a negative x squared, the 2x, and then these guys cancel out, so their difference is x squared plus 2x. Okay, let's evaluate graphically. Algebraically, we put in the x's and it spit out a y value. Now let's do these two graphically. F of 0 says the input, or x, is 0, and we want to know what the output, or the y value, is in this case. So I go to the x coordinate 0, which is right here, and when I stand there, I go down, and it looks like the output, or the y value, is negative 2. Next one says f of 2, so again, the x is 2, and then the y is what I'm supposed to find. So I go to the x value of 2, I'm right there, I'm going to walk over to the y value, it looks like I need to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and the y value is 4. So basically I have this ordered pair 0, negative 2 that helped me get the y of negative 2 for the corresponding x, and I have this other ordered pair of 2, 4 that helped me get the 4 for the input or the x value of 2. Let's go do the same thing for the next one. F of negative 1 says go walk over to the x value negative 1. There I am at negative 1. Now how do I get to the y value? I go down 1, 2, 3, 4-ish it looks like. So it's right about there. So I'm going to just go ahead and approximate that the y value or the output is negative 4. And then f of 2, I'm standing at the x coordinate of 2. And it looks like I go 1, 2 up. Looks like it's going right through that ordered pair. So the output is 2. Again, the ordered pairs were negative 1, negative 4 that helped me get the output. And the other ordered pair was 2, 2 that helped me get the output of 2. First one, negative 4. Second one, 2. This question says, worldwide sales of computers have climbed as prices have continued to drop. The function f of x equals blah, blah, blah models the number of personal computers sold in millions during year X, where X equals 0 corresponds to 1990. So 1990 is our X value of 0, the way they want us to interpret it. And then 91 would be X equals 1, and all the way until 25, where we're in the year 2015. It says, estimate the number of personal computers sold in 2010 graphically, and then using the polynomial. So graphically, I just go to the year 2010, and then I go up, and it looks like the number of computers is close to 300 million, right around there. So we'll say approximately 300 million computers were sold in the year 2010. Now, using the polynomial, all I got to do is give it an input and see what the output is. So I look at f of x equals 0.29x squared plus 8x plus 19, but I have to be careful since x equals 0 corresponds to 1990. In the year 2010, I'm actually, 20 years away from 1990? So I should input an x value of 20. I shouldn't put the whole number 2010 into my function, because x equals 20 corresponds to 2010. So when I put the 20 in there and I evaluate it, it looks like I get 295. Again, units are millions because it said sold in millions. And that's pretty close to what I had gotten from the graph visually, which was close to 300 million. So 295 million according to the function were sold in the year 2010.